Kaya, and good evening. There's been a massive surge in Omicron cases in WA, more than doubling overnight. The state has recorded 645 new infections. But with less than a handful of people in hospital, the Premier isn't prepared to toughen restrictions yet.
A massive spike in case numbers, but authorities aren't surprised.
And we were expecting this. I mean, you might know, we've been predicting this, that this was going to occur.
Infections have more than doubled in just 24 hours. 643 new local cases reported, along with two more travel-related. While four people are currently in hospital, none are in ICU.
The climbing caseload has been far slower than the eastern states, and that's been a good thing for us. But obviously it's starting to grow pretty rapidly now.
Despite the surge, the Premier is standing firm on restrictions. He says tougher density limits or masks for school kids from year three are a last resort.
I'm not keen to put in place the 4 square metre rule unless absolutely necessary. And the thing about these things is they can go for a long time.
The government has also been forced to backflip on its limits to outdoor gatherings. It's now been raised to 200 people after complaints weddings and special get-togethers had to be cancelled.
It's quite clear while this government have had more time than any on the planet to prepare for COVID, they've been left scrambling.
The McGowan government also under fire for leaving GPs in the dark about guidelines for treating COVID-infected patients or the use of antiviral medication.
We are frontline staff and we are just wanting to ensure that our practices are ready and we have a clear idea about triaging and managing our patients with COVID-19.
It comes as children aged 6 to 11 can get the Moderna vaccine from tomorrow after it was given final approval from federal regulators. It's the second jab available to kids with Pfizer in use from the age of 5.
It's half of the adult primary dose, but it's the same as the adult booster dose.
While a week out from WA's border reopening, Qantas and Jetstar have added about 60 flights between Perth and the east. The first from Sydney scheduled to land just after midnight on the 3rd of March, with more expected before the Easter holidays in April. Natalie Forrest for 10 News First.